Shannon and I were really hoping to film out here with the view, but one, it's a little loud with the wind, and two, it's putting us a little bit in the dark.
Adjust your light balance.
It doesn't look too bad, but I'm also afraid of the wind, and oh well. And also, we would need to get the ramp, so maybe it's just not worth it.
Maybe it wasn't in the cards for today.
We'll just film inside.
We know very little about how to use this camera. A
It's just
regular
set on auto.
videographer would be like, just adjust your
I know how
settings.
to adjust the white balance.
You can try that. But it is too loud. I mean,
Yeah.
how about a microphone with
And we don't
us?
have a ramp up here.
Yeah, it's just the whole thing. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to the show.
Welcome to the show.
Welcome to the show.
It's time
to talk
about
our lives. We brought in a chair from the porch for Hannah to sit on.
Yeah.
Is it comfy? Oh, you can rock. Oh boy, I'm sorry, everyone.
I could spin too, but I'm locked in here.
All right, you're gonna break
See?
the house.
Okay.
All right, first some housekeeping.
That was my line.
Do
I
it.
have been saying that all morning as like a joke because we have something we want to say before the video. And so all morning I've said, before we begin, a little housekeeping. And Shane just took my
We
line.
need to have a conversation about who is saying what.
But when someone is obviously excited about a line, I came up with a little housekeeping.
All right, go ahead, do
And
your
then
line.
you just said for some
Do your line,
housekeeping.
and then am I doing the
It doesn't matter.
housekeeping? You
You
just do
know that
all
I
of it.
wanted to do the
You do
housekeeping.
all of it. You do all of it.
Before we get into today's video,
We're getting a divorce.
we have a little housekeeping to attend to.
There you go, you did it. Oh.
We are approaching 800,000 subscribers,
Thank you. Thank you,
which is
everyone.
so exciting and unbelievable. And we were trying to figure out what we should do to commemorate
This momentous
this
occasion.
momentous number. For 100,000, we revealed our nicknames, who is who.
Yep.
I think for 500,000, we made that joke video where I tried to kill you.
Yep.
And that's it. So
Now
then
we're arbitrarily doing 800,000.
800. Yeah, I mean,
Was
it seems, it's like, wow, you know, we were excited about it.
Yeah, so we decided we are doing a massive giveaway.
Yes.
It's gonna blow your mind what we're giving away. It's blowing our mind.
I know.
We're regretting it
We're
already.
jealous.
But there will be details. The only stipulation to be entered into this giveaway is you're gonna have to be subscribed to our channel.
For our 800,000 subscribers.
Now, I know we just made a video saying that we will never, ever, ever be like, subscribe, subscribe. But for the giveaway,
Just so you
we
know.
need some way of like,
Yeah.
controlling it. So
Yes.
that is what the stipulation will be. We'll announce it in another video once we hit 800, but get ready because the prizes.
I know.
I'm gonna enter.
I don't think you're allowed. Welcome to our February HelloFresh video.
Tonight we have a very special celebrity chef
Yep.
cooking with us, which means that Hannah and I have the night off. Drum roll, please. Let's please meet our celebrity chef.
Hi. Today we're making broccoli and carrot donburi with a fried egg over scallion lime rice with pickled radishes.
Thank you, Liz.
Broccoli, radishes, scallions, rice. Ooh, carrot eggs.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Soy sauce. Ooh, the carrots are already shredded. That saves time.
That's nice.
What are you, a spelt person?
We don't have a cutting board here. The Airbnb doesn't have one. So we're gonna use a plate.
You can just use the counter.
I know, but I don't know how clean it is.
Okay.
You know.
I was laying on there when I used the bathroom earlier.
So no one comment that we're not using a cutting board.
Yes, we know we're supposed to cut on the cutting board.
HelloFresh has more five-star recipes than any other meal kit, so you know you'll get something delicious. You can also save up to 28% by using HelloFresh versus grocery store shopping. And HelloFresh's pre-portioned ingredients mean there's less prep for you and less wasted food. You can add extra dinners or lunches to your weekly order, throw in extra proteins, or add in yummy meal complements like HelloFresh's best-selling garlic bread. HelloFresh donated over 4 million meals to charity in 2020 and is continuing to step up their food donations amid the coronavirus crisis.
Awesome.
Wait.
Go to HelloFresh.com and use our code 10SquirmyAndGrubs to get 10 free meals, including free shipping. Again, go to HelloFresh.com and use our code 10SquirmyAndGrubs to get 10 free meals, including free shipping.
Thank you. Beautiful.
All right, so that was our housekeeping for today. We hope you enjoyed it.
Oh, you did it twice.
Today's video is...
Have you ever heard the story of Icarus? Icarus conquered flight. He brought mankind into the sky with the whims that he created for himself.
Was Icarus a man?
I don't remember.
Or
maybe
a god. I thought he was a god.
Don't ruin my intro, please.
Okay, sorry.
Icarus, after he found a way to fly, got a little bit too cocky, and he flew too close to the sun.
Your name should be Icarus.
Melting the whims that he had made, which caused him to plummet back to Earth. Today's story is a little bit like that.
That is actually really true. I cannot believe that you brought that full circle, but this is a Shane Icarus moment.
Wait for the very end, because I am going to knock your socks off with how I wrap it all around and tie it all with a nice little bow.
Okay.
I'm doing this for all of you. You know, I have very few skills, but I sound like Icarus right now.
What the heck?
Alright, do you want to talk about, my knees?
Your knees? Yes. Yeah. So, if you'll notice, and a lot of you, I think, have noticed. Let's move this. Let's move it all the way around. Shane has...
Is that pressing the button?
No.
Oh.
I don't think so. I hit this one once. Shane's left leg is approximately...
2, 3 inches?
4.
3 inches
longer.
4 inches.
It might be if I got a tape measure. From the knee here, it really does look like about 3 or 4 inches. That might be 6 inches.
My one leg is a lot longer than my other.
Yes, his left leg is a lot longer than his right leg. And when we first met, I think I asked you why at some point.
Yeah, actually, the first thing you said to me was, "What's with your legs?"
Nope. Maybe you volunteered that info. Actually, no. What it was in your book, and I read that, so I think I just knew.
Yeah.
But I think a lot of other people would be curious as to it's not just the way that Shane is sitting. Like you might think he's just turned, and he is not.
My right femur is significantly shorter than my left, and that is because of a gruesome injury that I suffered. Many years ago, I don't like thinking about it. It literally gives me, makes my heart palpate to think about what happened.
Why are we making this video, then?
Well, because it's funny, also. It rivals the ramp story.
It's worse than the ramp story.
Yeah, it is, because I got hurt.
Because, you broke your leg.
So, we're going to tell you what happened. This isn't my book. If you've read my book, that story is in there.
We might have alluded to it over the years, when you broke your femur, but this is the full version. All right, Shane didn't like where the camera was, so we had to move it.
I felt, my button. Even your dumb chair.
Can we just put this back?
Yeah.
Can you not insult my chair when it was your button?
Anyway, I felt like the engine before I was like this.
Okay.
Hello, everyone.
So now we're here. We're going to begin. I'll start. I'll set the scene, okay?
Yes.
Shane was in 11th grade, and he was in his adaptive gym class.
Yes, it was a gym class for kids with disabilities.
Yes. And you were outside, right?
We were on the tennis courts.
On the tennis courts.
We were not playing tennis.
No,
you were not good at tennis.
Was everybody playing the same activity, or do you all play different things?
We were all doing a variation of the same activity.
Okay, which was soccer?
Soccer.
Okay. So, did you have, a one-on-one person, or was that person, kicking balls with everybody?
It was one gym teacher, 3 students,
mm-hmm.
I was the only one using a wheelchair,
mm-hmm.
and one TA, a student, mm-hmm. who was a senior, who happened to be a cheerleader that I had a bit of a crush on.
Wow.
That factors into this story.
But was she playing with the other students, or with you?
I don't remember. This day is really a blur.
I'm sure you forgot much of
what
happened.
She and I were friends,
Yeah.
So I imagine she was like near me and we were like talking.
Yeah.
I was trying to show off though. I know that much.
And how did you show off for her? What did you do?
Well, when I found out that the activity of the day was soccer.
Which you loved.
I love soccer. I was like, oh, I bet you know how I like can't really do soccer in my chair, huh? Like, I'll show you. You're going to be amazed by how I can pass the ball and, like, collect it when someone passes it to me. I can dribble it with my wheels. I'm a big deal, if you're a said. So, we are passing them. There's a bunch of light balls. We're passing them around. I use my wheels to stop the ball, and then I back up, and I hit the ball with the middle of my chair on the bottom to pass it or shoot it or whatever. Having a grand old time, I say to the TA, do you think I can hit the ball from this spot all the way over there, like far away? Like, you know, you think I can? She's like, no way. I'm like, I can.
Shane, you seem like you might be the exact same person now that you were in 11th grade. I don't think anything has changed at all. Anyway, so Shane starts backing up to hit this ball really far.
Yep.
And there's a crucial detail here that I think we have to point out right before he hits this ball.
Yes.
He did not have his straps on.
Yeah, back then I didn't wear them every day.
Really?
Most days I wore them, but on some days I was like a stubborn piece of poop.
Like a rebel?
Yeah, and I was like, I don't need them. This is more of my Icarus. Like, you know,
this is the Icarus part.
I don't need my straps.
Yeah.
So I didn't have them on that day.
Wow. So Shane, unstrapped, is backing up.
Okay.
And how far away do you think from the ball you got?
I don't know, 30 feet maybe?
30 feet?
I was far away. It was pointless because my chair gets up to top speed in like 5 feet. I didn't need 30, but I was being grand. I was...
Yeah, what are you being obnoxious?
I was showman.
Ew. So Shane speeds towards this ball and connects with the ball. And it is underinflated. It's not a super inflated ball.
Yes, which I did not know.
So it got, instead of launching, it got lodged underneath your chair.
And in a moment, moment that will forever be seared in my mind, I made impact. My chair went up over the ball and sideways, flipping me out, like tossing me out,
because
I didn't have my straps on, and I went black, like I completely lost consciousness.
Wow.
I woke up a few seconds later on the pavement of the tennis court. My head is bleeding. I like blinked myself awake, and I'm like, oh boy. Oh wow. I'm like completely numb because it all happened in such a terrifying, like, few milliseconds.
Yeah.
I'm just like, ah. The gym teacher sprints over. I did not fathom what that looked like to him.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh my god, like, don't move. Like, I'll get help. And I was like, I can't move. I was like, I'll get help. I was like, no, I think I'm fine. Like, can you lift me back into my chair? He was like, no.
Yeah.
Your head is bleeding. I just saw you catapult out of your chair. I don't know what's wrong with you. I need to go get help. I was like, I really think I'm fine. Like, I'm hurting. My head hurts. But otherwise, like, I kind of did a little assessment. I was like, I feel okay. All right?
This is so disturbing, Shane. I know this is so disturbing. So, I mean, I feel terrible for this gym teacher, but he should not have lifted you. What if you had, like, a neck injury and you needed to be stabilized?
We had a lot of conversation after the fact, and he felt absolutely horrible.
Yeah, I feel terrible for him.
I love him to death. Like, he's a great guy.
Yeah.
And
with you laying on the ground, like, there's, you know, are you supposed to yield to the person who, like, the kid who can't get up and is like, absolutely, I'm not laying here. Lift me up right now.
Yeah, I mean, I was very persuasive. I swear I'm fine. So.
So, the gym teacher You're on your side, I guess?
I'm on my side, yeah. Kind of crumpled into like a little pile.
Fetal position?
A little pile, yeah.
And also, did your chair tip over?
No, somehow it didn't.
Okay.
In some way,
so if you had had your straps
out.
On, you would have been fine.
Yep.
That's too bad. Because I was thinking maybe if the chair was like upside down, it really saved you that you didn't have your straps on, but no.
Nope.
Okay, just wondering.
Tossed me out.
Tossed you out and kept rolling. Okay. So the gym teacher would have put his arm underneath Shane's head, like underneath his neck and underneath his knees, much like, you know, you've seen me lift Shane before, and then would have lifted you off the ground.
And when he did, I felt a pain that I hope no one on earth ever has to experience.
Ugh.
I felt, and if you're squeamish, end the video here.
Or mute, yeah.
I felt the bones in my femur pull themselves apart under the weight of me being lifted. I shrieked.
Oh my god.
He stopped immediately, and I was like, I think my leg might be broken, but I still want you to lift me back into my
chair.
What
is wrong with you?
I don't know. I thought it'd be fine.
Well, and you were also probably still trying to impress this girl and didn't want to be laying on the ground.
Yeah.
You
I was so beyond that at that
really?
Point. Yeah.
Then why?
The pain was like blinding. I didn't want a spectacle. I remember
that's what
that.
I'm saying.
Yeah, yeah. No,
you're
right.
You're still thinking
yeah.
about other people's, you know.
Yeah.
What they're going to see.
Yeah.
I don't, because otherwise, why would you want to sit up on that leg?
I don't know.
Is about to get so disturbing.
But yeah, so he lifted me. I felt the bones pull apart. He put me in my chair, which rearranged the bones again. I am, like, beside myself right now. But we get me situated. I drive to the nurse's office, where I tell her that I don't think it's broken. I think I might just have pulled a muscle.
What?
Why I thought that,
oh.
I have no idea. But she was like, all right, I'm going to, like, touch your knee. And she did, and I was like, ah! So she was like, yeah, I think you should go to the ER. So we called my mom, who came and picked me up. We went out to the van. I don't know why we didn't call 911.
You probably refused.
I probably
refused.
You were
like, I'm not riding an ambulance.
Or they called my mom, and my mom was like, no, I'll take him.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely.
Because then they
would
have had to
yeah.
transfer you and all that.
Yeah. By the time I was back in my chair, I was like, I am not moving again forever. Because that hurts really bad. So my mom picked me up. We had to go over speed bumps in the parking lot to get out. And that was like, never want to feel that pain again.
Oh my god.
Went to the hospital. They were like, your femur, well, we did x-rays. They gave me morphine.
That's good.
Like, right away, which helped. Because they were like, yeah, your leg is messed up. Did x-rays. My femur, and this is why my leg is shorter than the other, went up over itself. And during the repair process, which involved putting me under a few times, they determined.
Did they do surgery?
Yeah, kind of.
Oh.
But they determined that my leg could not support pins.
Yeah.
Like, I'm too frail. So they were like, we're gonna cast it over itself the way it is. And I have a shorter leg.
Wow.
And I had to approve that. But I was like, yeah.
So you had a huge cast on your leg.
It was my whole leg, yeah.
Your whole leg.
I didn't sit in my chair.
So 3 weeks in a hospital bed at home. But first you were in the hospital for like a week, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So like a month of this cast in bed. What was that like? What's your recollection of that time?
It was not fun.
I didn't think so.
I had to use a bedpan.
Oh.
In my living room, which my family was joyous about. I never used a bedpan to poop until that moment.
Hmm.
It's really hard to go laying down.
Shame.
Or it was for me.
Mm-hmm. I don't think we need to go that much into detail about that one specific part. Did you like missing school or were you like upset?
No, they made me do all my schoolwork at home. They had tutors come over. That was not fair. I should have gotten that time off.
What the, like when I had the chicken pox, I stayed home for 2 weeks and didn't have to do school.
I think the problem was like a month would have
been.
I would have gotten a lot like way behind.
You would have gotten behind. Poor you.
So that was the story of how I broke my leg, why my leg is shorter.
Hmm.
To wrap it up, my favorite poem, or one of my favorite poems of all time, begins with something like, can't remember the words exactly, people often forget that Icarus also flew. The whole Icarus story is about, you know, his plummet, but they overlook the fact that he figured out how to fly. And for that glorious moment, he flew.
Is that what you felt in the, on the tennis court?
That Icarus also flew. I flew. You like that bow tie? I put a nice little ending on that for all of you.
Wow. That was, yeah. That's nice. I mean, that sounds like a nice poem. I don't really think that it applies to you in this situation.
I think it's a great.
Which part of the story is your flight?
My triumph of, well, no.
When the ball lodged under your chair? Or
I guess my run up to the ball.
When you embarrassed yourself in front of the girl?
My run up to the ball when I was like, I'm going to do it. I'm flying.
That was your flight?
Approaching the sun.
That was what you, that's akin to Icarus flying towards the sun. You think very highly of yourself.
So Icarus.
All right, everyone. We hope you enjoyed the story of Shane's horribly broken femur and his shorter leg.
Yep.
It's all something you probably didn't wonder about, but now you know.
Now
isn't
you
that
know.
Like the theme of our channel? You probably didn't wonder about this.
That should be the name of our channel. Yeah. You don't care, but. All right, everyone. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.